Hello and welcome to Kia's Board, my podcast about knitting, spinning and other crafty stuff. And today it's a regular podcast. My last episode was a special one where you came with me to Sextigon and Nord, where I had my little spinning teaching spinning. And that was an extra episode, so that doesn't affect my regular podcasting. So today I'm back again with the ordinary stuff, and I want to start today by telling you about my finished object. One of them. I have a lot of finished objects for you today. But this one was a typical Kia thing to do. Last weekend we were going on a trip, a car trip to my son again, and my grandson, who came 1 year old last weekend. And I had to plan some car knitting, because it's 7-8 hours in the car. Back and forward. So I had to plan something, and this is a cardigan I have been it's been on my wish list for a long time. I think the first time I saw it was Nicole in The Gentle Knitter. She was wearing this one on an episode, and Patricia in Knitography from Norway, she has also been making this sweater. So I think it's a fantastic sweater. It looks fabulous, and it's knitted in Plötuluppi. It's the kind of yarn that isn't spun. That's just like this. So it's very, very easy to break. But you can mend it as easily as you break it. So. Very, very gentle hand when you knit it, but I think not. It wasn't so very. It didn't break when I was knitting, but if it stuck in the basket and I pulled, that's when the yarn broke, but not while I was knitting. I don't knit that hard, so maybe if you're a very tight knitter, you can have a problem, but I didn't think it was a problem. And I started to knit extra large on the bottom, but I decreased into a large up here. So I did a large yoke and extra large. It's a bit bigger at the end. And I also did some extra rows in the back, in the neck, because according to pattern you just knit, I think, 2 or 3 rows after this yoke, and then you bind off. You do the ribbing and then you bind off. But I did, I think, 6 rows back and forward here in the back, so I could raise the neck a bit. Otherwise, it's the pattern. I did smaller arms, because I started with the body, and when I should cast on the arms, I counted the amount of stitches that I should cast on for the sleeve, and it was very much, very, very big. So I did, I think I took 15 stitches away. So I tried it on as I knitted it, and I think I got a fitted sleeve, but I think it's fine, because it's a bit stretchy, this material. So, and I also did this ribbon, you called it, on the inside. Both sides, and this is the same as I used to my dress. I put a ribbon here to cover my mistakes. But I have a lot of this. I bought it second hand a couple of years ago. A whole like a skein, or I think I don't know how many meters. It's very many meters. And I also used metallic buttons that I had in my stash. So I'm very pleased with this sweater. As I finished it last night, I didn't want to. I wanted to wear it all the time, but it's a warm, very warm sweater. And out here in my barn, it's perfect. But inside, I couldn't wear it, not too long. But it's very, very cozy, and I love this joke. And the black and the white is super. Thank you, Nicole and Patricia, for inspiration to knit it in black and white. Very, very nice. So, that's my first finished object. And maybe I should tell you that it took 1 week exactly. I started on Thursday night. And I finished it yesterday, and yesterday was Wednesday. So 1 week to knit a whole sweater, but I had 8 hours in the car just to sit and knit. So, but anyway, it's a very, very fast knit with Plötterloopy, and it's knitted on 4 millimeter needles for the body and 3.5. for the ribbings. So that's Rusty cardigan, and the designer, I can put the name here because it's an Icelandic name. And my next finished object is the ranunculus sweater that I was knitting on the last time I podcasted, and it's finished. I made it with the long sleeves and a little bit longer body than my summer top, because I did this in the summer. It's a pink version with short sleeves and no sleeves and a little bit shorter body. And this one is with long sleeves and a little bit longer. And it's drops merino, superwash merino. And I'm not very used to knit in superwash yarn, but when I finished it, I took it in the washing machine for a short program, and when I took it out, I thought I ruined it, because it was twice as big as this, and this lace up here is, it was like a fishnet, you know, very, it was, no, you couldn't see the lace, it was just, I thought maybe, I can throw that one away now, but I put it in the dryer for a little short 10 minutes maybe, and as I took it out, it was back to normal again. So that the superwash thing, I don't understand it. I only did one thing in superwash before, but it's maybe it's not supposed to wash in the machine, or it's knitted on, I think, six millimeter needles, so it's not a very tight knit, and that's why it grew so much. But finished object, and my husband and I, we had a lovely day in the forest the same week as it was finished. So I can put some pictures here if you haven't seen them on Instagram. It was a perfect day in the forest, I must say. Very nice. And at the same time, when we were in the forest, I also took pictures of my long stockings. I finished them, and they are knitted in Crazy Sauber ball yarn, and one ball, 100 grams. It was enough. I think on the second On the second sock, I had two more rows of the contrasting color here on the toe. So if you want to knit long stockings, you can start with a little bit longer ribbing here on the top, and then you should be safe to knit too. And I started by 88 stitches on the top, and I'm also a tall person, so if you are a smaller person, you don't have to do so many stitches up here, and you don't have to knit so long, and then you should be safe with the ball. But I'm very pleased. I have three long stockings, so I will continue. I think they are perfect, very warm and cozy on your legs. So that's also a finished object. And something else I have been doing. I got a message from Pia Kammerborn, and she asked me if I wanted to test knit her mini Visby mini mittens. And of course I did it. It's not a very big project, so I think 1 hour and then I was finished. Maybe two, I don't know. But I realized when I was finished with them that they fitted Ulrik, my little sheep that I knitted this earlier this year. And so I made one more mitten for Ulrik and a little sweater. So this pattern is now released and is on Ravelry, and you know she did the big version before, and now she did this. I think she was sick the weekend and she just played around, and she did this fabulous little mini mittens. And Patricia, we say in Sweden, Patricia from Knitography, she did blockish for this mini mitten, super cute. So Ulrik is warm and cozy on his hands and also on his body. So that's also a finished object. Yes, I have one more. I forgot. I have been making one of the Christmas knits for Christian's daughter. She has two teenagers, and I am knitting them just this mittens, half mittens, and they are a very quick knit. I think 2-3 hours for one. Very very quick knit, easy knit, on 3.5 millimeters needles, and this is Camarosa Lammull, very very soft yarn. Very, I think these boys, they are a bit sensitive to itchy wool, so but this will be perfect. I have gray, blackish gray, to knit one more pair for the other guy, but this is also finished Christmas knit now. Perfect. I only have to do the black ones, and then I have a color half mitt with colors. So then I'll be finished for this year with my Christmas knits. That's great. Ongoing projects. I don't have very many ongoing projects. I started up a sweater before. After I finished the Ranunculus, I wanted to start a sweater, and I have been. I bought some yarn earlier this autumn from this book. It's a Swedish designer, Erika Åberg. Knit warm and colorful. And the sweater I am knitting is this one. And I'm knitting it as a cardigan. So I started up this sweater, I think 2 days maybe I knitted on this, and then we decided to go to my grandson, and I started off this one, so I had the car knit. I didn't think this was a car knit. It's too much to hold in your head with the patterns and the book and the... No, not car knit for me. So, I am on the go with this, and it's a super cozy wool. It's a Norwegian wool, and a Swedish yarn dyer, Tant Kofta, is buying from Norway, and she colors it herself in different colors, and she is very, very, very talented dyer. So, this is Norwegian wool and the Swedish designer. So I think it will be a nice sweater when it's finished. Maybe I can finish this one this year, and that will be number 20 for me. I have on my blog, on my website, I have a series of sweaters that I have knitted 2018. So if you want to, you can go and have a look. I'm writing it in Swedish, but you can look at the pictures. It's stickade tröjor. I can write it here, and you can check it out. So that this one is number 19 for this year, and this is 20. But we will see if I get to finish it this year. If I don't, it's okay. I can keep it up. I want this to be a great project, because this is a bit finer yarn, I think. A little bit more precious to me than this Plutalopi is. Not very expensive, and you can buy it in any shop. But this is a bit more special, I think. So I want it to be a good project. So that's one thing on my needles. And I also have this Aito shawl. But I haven't been knitting on this one at all, since I showed it to you the last time. But I have had other things to do, but I will pick this one up. I definitely will, because it's a very, very nice project. And it's also knitted in same kind of yarn as Plutalopi, but this is a Swedish wool. So, yeah, I think I will get there very soon. And that's all my ongoing projects. I have been very much inspired from this book. It's a Norwegian book, and super lovely patterns in this one. And the one that has inspired me the most, this will definitely be my next cast on. It's, look at this. This is knitted vests. So handsome. So this will be my next thing that I will knit. And as I was looking in this, there is also some other... Maybe I can show you. Yeah, here it is. Here. Look at this jacket with the waistband. And when I saw this picture, there is also other designs in the same style. And I wanted to try something. So I just knitted like a belt, like this, on the round needles, and I am making it to a belt. I will stick it in the back, and I will knit with the dark grey some triangles, I think, to, and then braid, braid, two braids, two triangles and two braids, and then knit it in the back. And I have a light gray dress. So if I have I have the dress and I have this one in the waist, and I will knit two for the arms as well, and maybe a collar to put on the top. So that's something I'm planning and trying out. It's just playing around, but with the inspiration from this book, because it's super lovely. I love the Norwegians. They really hold on to their traditions with with the dresses and everything. So yes, I think we should be a little bit more like the Norwegians here in Sweden. But I'm taking some ideas from that book, and I'm making them to details to maybe put on some of your own clothes. You don't have to knit all the whole dress. Maybe you can take something you have and just put on some details. So that's something that I am working on. And spinning wise, I finished my sock yarn, and last night I was plying it. And this is Corriedale bamboo. And I know I have been saying that Sundays are my spinning days, but for two weekends now I haven't been able to spin, because first I was at the event 60 Gone Nord, and then this Sunday I was at my grandson. So last afternoon I sat down by my wheel and I finished this. And I started to ply at 8:30 last night, and it takes 2 hours, a little bit more than 2 hours to ply this bobbin. It's a bobbin. So it's a bit hard work to do the plying, and but after you have done that, it's finished. So now I have only to wind it up, and then I have a finished skein to knit. I think socks. I haven't decided, but I think it will be some kind of Christmas socks. Can I wear it with this? Maybe I do socks and I have this for the dress. Maybe. But finished. What have I been buying since the last time? I did buy this Plötuluppi for this dress, this sweater. And I also bought a magazine from, it's from Finland, Novita. I saw this as I was in the supermarket, and I just looked very quickly. And the first thing that I saw when I read felted socks for the whole family, and that's perfect, because I always have scrap yarns from wool, and I can knit them and felt them to nice cozy socks. So that's the first thing that I saw that I wanted to look at. And when I was looking in this magazine, I saw this wool dress. And look at the details up on her shoulders there with the tassels and everything. It's perfect. And also she has two lovely Siberian Huskies. Same as my Nemo, but my Nemo is white and gray, and she has black and white. And also some lovely mittens. Look at this. Yeah, so I had to buy this. This is a very, very nice magazine, I think, from Finland, Novita. And they also have yarns for everything. They have their own yarn brand. So that was something I bought. And I also bought in Sweden, we have, maybe some of you have heard of her, she is Caroline Henkelius, and she has Höner & Eir. And she and her partner has bought a spinnery here in Sweden, and they are working very hard to get this going. And now they have two of the big drum carders, the machines, the big machines, working. So she was able to offer us some wool if we wanted to buy and try to spin ourselves. And of course I wanted to try. She's very, very inspiring, I must say. But you have to be a Patreon to look at her videos, but she's worth it, yes. You get really, really inspired by her and all her things, and she's into natural things, and she only uses Swedish wool and very close to home wool, so it don't have to travel so long. So yeah, very, very nice. And she has a Facebook group that's called Zäta Spinneri. I will put here and links on my website that you can go in and check Zäta Spinneri, because you can follow the progress that they are making to finally get this spinnery going. And it will be so exciting to see the yarn that she will produce. She's dyeing the wool, and yeah, very nice. I'm holding my thumbs that it will be a success for her, this. So I have some wool here. I was now that I have spun up what I had on my wheel, I can start with this. So this will be very nice, and It smells very much sheep, so nice. I think this is everything for today, and I hope that you are having a nice Advent, because this Sunday is the first Advent, and I have been making putting up candles in the windows, and cleaning the windows, new curtains, and you know, you start with one thing and the next comes along. There's always something. And if you are like me, you don't put very much time on cleaning. You put your time on crafty things like knitting and spinning, and yeah, that's always the first priority in my house. Let's turn off the lights and light up some candles, and we don't have to see that it's cleaning time. Wherever you are in the world, I hope that you will have a nice time up to Christmas, and don't be too stressed about everything. There will be Christmas anyway. So drink some tea, light up some candles, and enjoy this cozy month that we have ahead of us. And I will see you maybe one more time before Christmas. Bye bye!